Join us as we take on the challenge of creating our dream customer avatar using only Google Gemini. Let's see if we can nail it today. When it comes to targeting the right audience for your business, having a clear customer avatar is crucial. It's the foundation of any successful marketing strategy, as it helps you understand who your ideal customer is, what their pain points are, and how you can tailor your message to resonate with them. Yet many businesses struggle to identify their target audience, which can lead to marketing efforts that fall flat. Without a clear customer avatar, you're essentially shooting in the dark, hoping that your message will somehow magically resonate with somebody somewhere. But the truth is, this approach rarely yields results and can be a huge waste of time and resources. When you don't have a clear customer avatar, you're more likely to attract tire kickers rather than genuine leads. You're also more likely to create content that misses the mark, and ultimately, you're more likely to struggle to scale your business. On the other hand, having a clear customer avatar can help you attract high-quality leads, create content that resonates, and develop a marketing strategy that drives real results. It's no wonder that many businesses struggle to identify their target audience. After all, it's not always easy to pinpoint your ideal customer, who they are, especially if you're just starting out. But the good news is that there are tools and strategies that can help. And that's where Google Gemini comes in. This powerful tool can help you create a detailed customer avatar by exploring data insights and trends that reveal customer behaviors and preferences. Now, my business partner Mercer has some thoughts on how you can build your customer avatar with Gemini and recently shared them in a private training at Profit School. And today, I want to open up that session for you to see exactly how to get started with building and improving your avatar. So let me hand this one over to Mercer.
So here is a technique I will give you with avatars that works incredibly well. We have Maria, David, and Anya. Maria, we're testing avatars now. Write a journal entry about her generally that reflects her typical day. Now, I didn't do the super prompting thing, power ping pong it back and forth, because I don't have to, because that's how I started this chat. So it's already in the right place. So now I've got, okay, Maria is talking about what's going on, evidently came out today, or technically in the future with my time. So I'm going to paste this in. So now I have Maria's journal entry talking about things. Tone of voice is going to be in there. Pain points are going to be in there. Different ways of describing things are going to be in there, which is what I want. It's what I need, because I need the avatars doing this. Imagine if you could talk to a customer. Imagine if I could talk to all of you for 15 hours and just record it. And all you were doing was talking to me all the stuff that was relating to the business and how, you know, you were using my products and services and everything else. How amazing would that be to have recorded? It would be awesome. I don't have that, but I can get it with AI and it can simulate it, so I can at least get the spirit of what I'm trying to do. So then I'm going to do the same thing. And this is where you can sort of help it repeat. This time have Alex do it. So now Alex is going to write a typical journal. Oh, it did not repeat that. Okay, let me show you a technique. When this happens, you can do two things. When you get an unexpected response, you can just regenerate it or you can reprompt it. You can sort of start over. When you see this edit text, it means you can start over here, and then this will go away and you can reset it. When you come up and you've already done a prompt, you'll notice I cannot edit this one because it's locked now. It's already had a response and I prompted again, which means I can't change this one. So what I'm gonna do is just do this. I'm just gonna copy and be like, it didn't quite work. That's fine. I'm just gonna paste this back in. And Alex, writer journal, reflects his typical day. And I'm just gonna say there, so I don't have to keep doing it.
Alex is not one of the personas.
Oh, it's, you know what? David, you're totally Anya. Right. It's David, yeah. Anya. I'm used to Alex is one of my personas. But to this point, if I had read that, it would have been like, you asked me to do something for something I don't know. Then I told it to do it, so it did it. But you see the difference with AI is never going to lie to you, but it'll totally lie to you. It won't give you a useful result, which is exactly right. So I did not give it. I gave it a prompt. It gave me an answer, but that answer wouldn't have been right. This hallucinated the entire thing because I told it to.
No, actually, it said I'm assuming you meant Anya.
Oh, even better. Yeah. Even better. This is Anya's. Yeah, thank you for that. This is because as I'm teaching and going too fast here. So that's perfect. Thank you for the catch. So we're going to take Anya's code. Brilliant. But again, this is where I'm like, oh, thanks, AI. You're actually helping me with a even better. And now we're going to do the same thing. Who are we missing? David. Okay, cool. So now we're going to do same thing for David. Now I should catch it. Too many AI names on the brain. There we go. So now we've got David's. Now, the other thing that I would suggest, actually, I'm just going to copy. So the other thing that I would suggest that you do is have the day before. Imagine now, think like, and this is where your own experience comes in as a human side of skills, where you're a business owner side of skills, as a manager side of skills, when you're working in copy, as a you need to know what the typical, avatar is thinking, but you also want to know like, what was life like before? What was life like after? So now we can say, great job. I don't mind giving it a, I like giving a little bit of feedback of like, hey, this was the current direction. I like where you're going. Keep going this direction. Please have, make sure I get the names right now. Maria, write a journal from the day before she, I'm gonna say they, keep it as easier, they joined private school. So now I get, here's all the issues they were having right before. In other words, what was life like before you solved everything with Profit School? So now I've got, okay, it's my journey to the world of AI. I'm finally hitting that enroll button. Here's why I'm going to do it. It's a bit of a blur. I managed to seek in last minute research, right? So it's like, here's why I went to purchase. Okay, now, right? Journal entry from the day after she joined private school. So now it's the day before and the day after. Then, now I'm going to put this little piece in there. Please be specific. Because now this is my results thinking mentality. This is again, this is the human part kicking in where I go, if I can get her to tell me about what life is like in a typical day. I kind of have the basics. Then I get the day before. Okay, here's what was really happening. Here's what moved me over the needle. Here's what life was like after I started doing it. Here's my initial impressions. And then this is the stuff that is in it, it's imagining would be the really useful stuff. Here's the things I really liked focusing on, right? So we can go through that. So now I've got my avatars. Now, I'm not going to have time to do the quality control part of this, but you absolutely want to do the quality control part of this. So you're going to come through here and you're going to say, okay, is this make sense? Is this, have I talked to this customer before? That's the easiest way to do it. If you're like, oh my God, I know this person, like it's Dave or it's Sarah or it's Bill or whatever the person's name is that you know, and you're like, this is exactly who they are, then you nailed it. That's it. If you go, I've never had a conversation like this with an avatar, you just got to go back. No big deal. Like in this case, I already can tell you, Python and data analysis, it's already a slightly bit off. I would go back and adjust it and be like, hey, our avatars are into AI, but they're beginners. They're not folk and they're not technical. And I would have it redefine that because I can tell based on these journals that they're going in a more like technically, let's talk about APIs and coding and building apps type of AI, which I understand why it thinks that, but that's not what I want it to do. So the reason this is happening is because it doesn't know profit school. So what could I do that might help it understand how to build an avatar that is more suited for profit school? And this is where we're going to do one little more technique of an instruction build, and then we're going to combine everything together in this next hour, and then we're going to start creating our gems with it. So I have instructions for my avatar. What I don't necessarily have, though, is everything about Profit School, and it's making everything up. It's going, oh, this coaching company called Profit School teaches AI. I'm going to assume that means all this stuff, and that's where it's coming up with these avatars. And I can see it doing it because I can get the journal entries, and it's faster and easier for me to go like, yeah, I've never talked to a customer like this, so I don't know how useful they are. So one quick thing I will tend to do here is I'm just going to pin, but I'm going to call this DNU, just so you can see it. And I'm going to put a little red X as in not useful. So now I have it up there. So here's my little do not use is what DNU stands for, just so I can kind of see it there. So only because I want to be able to reference it for you later. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new chat and I'm going to say, please research please create a research. Research and create a report about profit school so you fully understand its business model, courses, and likely competitors. Okay, so now we're going to ping pong. Again, I'm going to keep it really simple. I'm just telling it basically what I want. Make sure I'm in the right model, which I am, which is Flash. So I'm going to first do this. It's going to iterate a bunch of times. It's going to say, well, here's the things you probably really should have asked me. So what level report, each section, business model, document format, which is fine. Pricing structure, it's going to make up. That's fine. I don't care right now. Purpose of the research, evaluate profit school's potential competitor in online market, which is true. Currently, the company offers business courses. Want to see courses for profit school worth the price. That's great. But the feedback. Okay, so I'm going to say that's one more thing. Please revise your understanding. This report can also be used by virtual a source document for virtual avatars to learn about Profit School. So now it's going through again. It's going to language everything. Actionable knowledge. The avatar's knowledge is going to depend on it. So it's going to be a little more details. All right. So now, good enough. I'm going to ping pong. And now we're going to get our prompt. And I'm already going to anticipate the prompt's going to come in a specific direction because I'm not telling it to do deep research, but that's what I'm going to ask it to do. So please rewrite this prompt so it is suitable for Gemini. So I'm gonna, specifically is what I should have said, specifically. And the reason is that I'm saying specifically for is because it's going to know certain things about working with deep research that I have no idea. So I want it to tell itself what to do because I don't know. I don't want to have to go Google, here's how to unlock Google deep research. I just want AI to just do it, right? So, and can be copy and pasted. So now I'm going to get my little copy and paste block. Perfect. So now I'm just going to copy that. Now I'm going to do a new chat. I'm going to flip the model into deep research. I'm just going to paste it. I'm going to do a very quick cursory glance here just to make sure it's going to be something useful, at least likely to be useful. So executive summary, business model, let's find revenue streams, course analysis, okay, deep research stuff, virtual avatars, data for virtual avatars, that's excellent. Curious is doing the machine readable file. That's because it's writing itself so the AI can read it because it wants structured data. And this is how AI thinks. So it's going to do that. And then here's the specific directions and let's find out what happens. So I'm just going to let it do its processing. And what we're waiting for is two things. One is it either starts giving me a bunch of answers, which normally that's taking a wrong turn because I really wanted to say, oh, here's my plan. And it should give me that little block that says, here's what I'm planning to do in research. And then we're just going to double check that to make sure, yeah, is this kind of in the general, the right idea that I want? Sometimes it's the exact duplicate of the prompt because again, it got its prompt from itself. So it's already pretty much there. Sometimes it's a complete rewrite of the prompt. But in this case, it looks like everything's pretty decent. So I'm going to go ahead and hit start research. At that point, it says, cool, I got it. I'm working on stuff. You go hang out, take care of whatever you need. I'm going to be building this out. So I've got my instructions already built for the avatar. I'm about to build an entire research report that is all about Profit School. Then I'm going to go back to those avatars. And this is why I'm showing you this process. So we started with the avatars that were like, okay. Then we got them a lot more specific and a lot more sort of psychographic, voice of customer, a little more vibrant coming in. But they started going in, not really our avatar anymore for Bravo School. Initially, they totally look like the avatar. And then they, when you hear them talk, or in my case, when we see them or read them, you know, as they're going through, they don't come through. We can see here it's already going through Profit School, different sites. What I will be very curious to see is if it does competitive sites, because that part might have fallen out, but I would like it to do competitive sites, so we'll see. It's also got stuff that is not necessarily our version of Profit School, which you can see down here coming through. But what it's doing, oh, there we go, 109 different websites now. How fast was that? So for me to go through and research all about Profit School and competitive analysis, imagine you just building that. You're going to need it anyway for your company. Why not? So now you got this thing created. I have my avatar, how to build an avatar created. Combining them, this is going to be a superpower, at least in a perfect world.
By using Google Gemini, you can create a customer avatar that's tailored to your target audience's specific needs and preferences. With ping pong prompting, you can improve on this avatar with each pass. Then you can use this avatar to develop marketing content that resonates and create a sales funnel that drives real results. And the best part, it's easier than you think. In today's video, Mercer showed you the importance of having a clear customer avatar and how Google Gemini can help you create one. Now remember, your customer avatar is the foundation of any successful marketing strategy, and with Google Gemini, you can develop one that drives real results. So there you have it. What are your thoughts on customer avatars? Share your experience in the comments below, and be sure to subscribe to this channel for even more effective strategies. And if you want to get the full training on how to create your avatar, be sure to sign up at ProfitSchool.com/Gemini today.